Hello and welcome. In this tutorial, I just wanted to show you how to go ahead and connect to external MDL paths that you might have created for your Omniverse projects. It is going to be very typical that people will want to create custom templates and they want to be able to access them through Maya. So in this tutorial, we're just going to be going through just how we do that exactly. So to begin, let's go ahead and start with our default setup in Maya. Let's go ahead and sign in. Now that we're signed in, let's go ahead and open up our Hypershade panel and see what we see. Excellent. Now, if we look in our list over here on the left, you'll see at the bottom that we have this MDL Materials and a library. If we select the library, we'll see that we have Omni Glass, Omni PBR, and Omni PBR Opacity. Now, these three material templates are going to be more or less everything that we ever need, except for rare cases. But those rare cases do come up, and you may or may not want to create specialized MDLs that you want to be able to reference through Maya to define specific types of materials. Another thing that you might do is create variants of the Omni PBR. So let's say you make a dark glass and a red paint or a red metal, right? Those are going to be what's called a material collection, okay? And we'll get into that in a little bit, but those are other variations that you might do. You might create from this Omni PBR multiple variations of that, and we're going to call those collections. There's technically no difference, but that's what we're going to do, is we're going to have these variations of these templates. So a base is called a template, and a variant of a base is going to be a collection. Okay, so just something that's kind of important to note as we move forward, but not super critical because technically they're all MDLs and they can all work synonymously, so it doesn't really technically matter. Okay, great. I don't want to get into too much detail on that. But let's say we want to add an additional material template to this list, or maybe material templates multiple, right? So how would we go about doing that? That's really the question here. So all we have to do is go up to our Omniverse and go Settings. And under Settings, you're going to see that we have a Material Template Search Path and a Material Collection. Again, Collections and Template Search Paths are basically the exact same thing. They both look for MDLs that are valid. And if there's a valid MDL within that search path, it's going to go ahead and present them in our Hypershade panel right here. Okay, so let's go ahead and do that really quick. I happen to have some MDLs on my Omniverse, so I'm going to hit plus. I'm going to navigate to my user folder where I created my MDLs, and I'm just going to select this My MDLs folder. Now here it's showing a resource. Don't worry about that. That's just a folder basically within side of here. We don't have to worry about that. All we need to do is grab the root of My MDLs, okay, and hit choose. And now you'll see that I have users, pkind, my MDL. So this is the path to my MDLs that I want to list here, okay? So I'm gonna hit apply. It's gonna give me a warning saying that, hey, I'm now gonna sync all this stuff. So it might take a second. So I'm gonna hit okay. It's gonna sync. And now it's saying you might wanna reopen your scene. Okay, so we're going to hit close. I'm working in an empty scene, so it really doesn't matter, and I'm not actually going to work from here. But I'm going to recommend that you go ahead and quit Maya to make sure that all your settings get saved. But I'm not going to do that for now. All right, so let's go ahead and tab this down, and we'll see that when I select My MDLs, I now have access to my PK RMA EM Simple material and my PK Skydome material. Okay, so I've now got my personal usage material and my personal usage Skydome. Okay, so this is very useful for me, and now I have access to those MDLs right here in Maya. So that pretty much covers how to add new materials. Now, the next thing you might want to do is have a template. Like I was saying, you can have variants of these. So let's say I had a bunch of these variations of a material. Let's say I created a red car paint and a blue car paint and a, I don't know, many different variations, right? We might want to have all those in one collection. Now we can go ahead and select a collection as well. So let's go ahead and do that, right? So let's go back to our Omniverse panel. Let's go to Settings. And just like we did before, we're going to go to this materials collections. And now I'm going to go to our library, materials, collections. I'm going to grab these vMaterials, 1.6, AEC. And here's a whole bunch of variants, right? And I'm going to hit choose. And now I'm going to hit apply. Hit OK. It's going to go ahead and sync just like it did before. And just like before, it's going to pop this warning open saying that we need to reopen our scene. Again, I don't have a scene that I'm actually working on open, and I would recommend that that's what you should do too. When you're setting up these things, you should probably do this while you're on a blank scene or just, but yeah, that's just my recommendation. Okay, so I'm going to close this window, and now I can see that under AEC, I have carpet, concrete, drywall, fabric, etc. Okay, so that basically shows you how to load up all sorts of types of MDL material templates and material collections right through the Maya interface. Okay, hopefully this was very helpful, and thank you for watching. Have a nice day.